Hey everyone, what's going on? Simon back here giving another video. We're just in the office right now, actually just quickly looking at the weather here, seeing what the next week or so is playing out. We're trying to schedule a couple cleanups in, and but I just wanted to hop on here quick and make a quick intro. I'm gonna go out and show you the plow setup now that we're probably 95% done with it. There's always something, a little something to do. We actually just had a little scare of an event last night. Nothing actually came down. The storm started to track north a little bit, which is more than fine by me. So I got the whole plow set up out there right now. I'm just going to go over it real quick and make a quick video for you guys. Hope you guys are doing well. Been super busy since equip, and it's just getting busier as we get closer to December and the snow season. So stay tuned.
Alrighty guys, so here is our 2023-2024 plow setup for this year. We're running a little bit of commercial but mainly residential snow plowing here. This is my, as you guys have seen before, 2018 F-150 XL with the snowplow prep package and heavy-duty payload package. It has the 5-liter Coyote V8 and 373 gears, four-wheel drive, of course. Up front, we have a 7.5-foot Meyer straight blade. I believe it is a Lot Pro. Recently, I have added this flap here, as well as the new cylinders for this plow, and also have changed the hydraulic fluid. So far, really enjoying this plow. Generally, it's super easy to operate and is pretty well built for a half ton plow. As you can see, it is a trip edge rather than a trip blade, which I think works just a little bit better for scraping the lots. I'm hoping next year to paint the plow and also put some new lights on it. Here we did have right here a few grill amber lights, but those have burnt out. They were only cheap ones, but looking to get some better ones here soon. They look super sick. If you look back in some of my older shorts, you can see those as well. Up top we have a buyer's warning light that came with the truck as well. If we come around to the back rack here, this is kind of my, the big treat on this truck is how much lighting I have back here. We have, I believe, this is a 20-inch light bar here, along with two pod lights on the reverse. And then on another circuit, we have a left ditch light, and then also a right ditch light on the on separate circuits as well. And down below the bumper here, just to shed a little bit more light when we're salting and doing some work behind the truck, there are two little pods down there. I do actually need to lower those, but for now they're just kind of tucked up out of the way and help a lot. As you can see, we're running a tailgate salter this year. This is a Boss TGS 600. I picked this up for like $1,500 used off Facebook Marketplace. We've already run a couple bags of salt through it. It is a pretty clean unit. I have to wash it out here before we take it off the truck, but it works pretty well. It is a bit of an older unit. It sat for a while, but overall a great unit. Works really, really well on this truck. It's pretty compact. It only adds about a foot or two behind the truck here, and it handles really well. We're just running a 50-pound bag salt, as you can see back here, just some Windsor safety salt. I found this to be the best so far as it's just the way the granulars are and availability and its melting power. We're still keeping the Cooper Discovery AT3s on this truck for the winter. They worked well last year, and they're gonna work well again this year. They got about 30,000 kilometers on them now though, so we're gonna get looking into new tires come the spring. You can see the other ditch light there. And yeah, as far as the outside goes, that's kind of everything. Again, 7.5 foot straight blade on the front, pairs really well with that Salter in the back and this truck. It is where it's a regular cab long box. It's pretty compact for what you get out of a truck nowadays without going to a short box, which of course going to a short box in this setup limits your hauling capabilities as well. So this is a really, really, really nice setup. And the straight blade and the Salter on the back only adds about 5 feet of length to the overall truck. All right, so jumping back inside, you can see we have our our aux beam controller with our right, left, rear, and strobe lights. I am looking to put a front light on, but just haven't got to it yet. This on-off button, if I have all these turned on, it will remember the last save and turn them all off at the same time and turn them back on. So as you're going between parking lots and driveways, you can kind of turn those on and off so as you're not blinding people and stuff like that. Moving to the center cluster, there's nothing really special about this, but this truck is equipped with the 4-inch screen there in the middle. And generally, every day, I like to run the off-road status, especially when plowing, because you can really see the pitch of the driveway and the way it's sloped, and adapt your plowing to it accordingly. And also, you know, it's good information to have to know what ground you are on. This is also equipped with Ford Sync. I think this is also a 4-inch screen here, so it easily connects with my phone. I can get my text messages and everything through that, and phone calls, which is really important when you're plowing, because you're constantly talking to employees or other contractors to kind of see what's up. If we just come up here, I have my GoPro, and there are a few other mounts around the truck on the roof, as well as the tailgate Salter here. I do plan on recording quite a bit of video this winter. And overall, that is the general look outside when the plow is down. Down here, this is my controller setup right now. It's a kind of a little bit of a mess with all the cords currently, but we have our plow controller as well as our Salter controller. We'll just go over this really quickly here. You flip this on, it is gonna do a blast as soon as you turn it on. And then from there, it'll set to whatever speed you have set. So generally, I keep the Salter empty and only put in as many bags as the lot requires. So then when I come into the lot, I turn it on, let the blast function, you know, cycle, and then load the salt. From there, I just play with the spinner, and that adjusts your spinner speed, which also kind of varies your feed and your length, or your spreading width at the same time. It's just one controller, so pretty basic. You also have your blast button, which is a 10-second blast for max speed on here. Here we have our Meyer controller. It is a Easy One controller, equipped with the it's equipped with a function that allows you to just use the transmission to lift and lower the plow. It detects forward and reverse. Right now we are in float. As you can see, we're down on the ground. So it is on. If we double tap up, the plow will automatically raise. And then double tap left, it'll go all the way to the left. Double tap right, it will go all the way right. And then hold, and it'll go into float. And then, of course, you can just hold it wherever you need it in between. But generally, pretty easy plow controller to use. I do feel that it is a little bit heavy, as you can see on the top end, but I guess it's kind of something you just get used to. Double tap down goes back into float, and that just sits right here next to the Salter controller. And of course, we have our tablet to run Jobber. We use Jobber for all of our routing and billing and customer needs, so it works great. Just right there, we can see our route, see our times, and it's just kind of a quick array of everything I need to know while operating this truck. So that's a quick overview of the 2023-2024 plow setup. Like I said, it's about 95% done. I would like to get the front grille lights working again, probably, as well as
I think I got to play with the plow lights a little bit too to kind of sort those out a little bit. But overall, the truck is complete for this winter. Basically, when I purchased this truck, we started out with just the plow and the truck. I've added the Salter, the back rack with all the lights. And so I'm very, very happy with how far this has come along and super excited to get plowing this winter. But just wanted to make a quick video for this week to show the plow off and you know, pretty proud of this setup, to be totally honest with you guys. It is pretty awesome to be 20 years old and have a plow and mow setup like I do. But we're going to keep pushing forward and make dreams come true. So thank you guys for watching. Really appreciate the support. Have a good one.